In this example, we will look at metabolism of a drug. In this case, we have a human where the blood volume, plasma volume is 6 liters, and they're given an IV, an intravenous injection that has 60 milligrams of some drug we'll call X. And then the drug reacts by a first order reaction. We're given the rate constant. The patient is consuming liquid, and 2 liters per day is the average value, and therefore losing 2 liters of liquid, so the plasma volume doesn't change. The drug itself is effective at treating the objective of the drug. If the concentration is above 5 milligrams per liter, but above a concentration of 12 milligrams per liter, then toxicity becomes a problem. So we're going to assume a single compartment, pharmacokinetic model, and we want to estimate the following. We want to estimate the rate the drug is removed from the body. It's referred to as clearance. We want to determine the half-life of the drug in the body. We also want to determine the length of time that this dose, this IV dose, is going to be effective. And then the time we have to wait before we can give another injection. By that we mean the time when we inject, we're still going to be below this toxicity limit. And so essentially we're looking at a simple model of this being a well-mixed reactor. So we have water, 2 liters per day that are coming into this well-mixed reactor. Its volume is 6 liters, that stays constant. So 2 liters per day is leaving. And at time equals zero, we're going to inject 60 milligrams of the drug. So at time equals zero, the drug goes in. It's a one-shot injection. So this is now a steady state system. We can essentially model it as a semi-batch reactor with constant volume and constant flow rates in and out. And we can then write a mass balance for the system. And in this mass balance, so what we're going to write a mass balance on is the reactor, the concentration of X. So the concentration of X in the reactor. So if we want to do it in terms of the change in the total mass of X respect to time in our 6 liters is due to the fact that we're flowing in drug. Well, we're not flowing any in, that's zero, but we are removing it. So we have this volumetric flow rate. We call this 2 liters per day, a volumetric flow rate V, and we have a concentration, a mass concentration of X. That's the concentration in the exit. Since it's well mixed, that's a concentration in the reactor, in the plasma. And then we have the reaction of the drug. So there's a rate constant, concentration times the volume. Now the mass can be written, the mass can be written as the volume times the concentration. Volume is constant, concentration, of course, is changing with time. And this is equal to this volumetric flow rate, rate constant, times the concentration. So the clearance, the first thing we're trying to calculate is this, the rate that we're removing. So 2 liters per day being removed, and then the rate constant is 0.3 per day. The volume is 6 liters, and this adds up to 3.8 liters per day. So clearance is rate term 3.8 liters per day. Well, we want to next solve this mass balance to get half-life so we can separate variables. Change in the concentration, mass concentration, divided by the concentration is V plus KV dt, and this is divided by volume. And what we're going to do is integrate from time equals zero to some later time. Concentration initially, so Cx initial in the reactors, we add 60 milligrams. It's well mixed. This volume is 6 liters. So the initial concentration, 10 milligrams per liter, immediately after the IV injection. So we want to integrate this equation. So we're integrating to some time, some general time, and therefore the concentration at that time. So left side is the log of the concentration at that time divided by initial concentration is 10. The right side, these are all constants, t minus 0. If we substitute the numbers in, so here is the equation that tells the concentration at any time, where, remember, the units of time is days, the units of concentration is milligrams per liter. So we're interested in the half-life. So half-life would be when the concentration is 5 milligrams per liter. The time would be t to the 1/2. So 5 over 10 means the log of 0.5 equals, and this means t is 1.09 days. Or this is the half-life, and the significant figures, let's say 1.1 days. So half-life, time to get to half the concentration. Well, the problem also asks, at what time will the dose no longer be effective? In other words, when does the concentration, in this case, be less than 5 milligrams per liter? Well, for this first injection, that's corresponding to the half-life. So we say it's not effective after 1.1 days. So, of course, in general, it's not going to be the half-life just for this particular problem. Otherwise, we'd substitute in a new concentration and can solve that equation the same way. And now the final part is we want to give a second dose, but we don't want to go above, so we don't want the concentration to be above 12 milligrams per liter because of toxicity. But we are going to add the amount that corresponds to a concentration of 10 milligrams per liter. So that means we only can add more drug, inject it. We can only inject this drug when our concentration in the reactor is 2 milligrams per liter. Concentration is 2. We inject corresponding to 10. We'll be right at 12, and that's as high as we want to be. So the question is, how long does it take from our original injection to get to 2 milligrams? So this equation, of course, is still valid for this reactor model. Cx equals 2. And we can solve, of course, for t. T is 2.5 days. So that means the time between the doses, 2.5 days. And that's the last part of the problem, is How long after the initial injection can we give a second injection?